Sup guys, my name is Courtney Budson and this is What's for Din. Today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make the classic stuffed peppers. Now I think the problem when it comes to stuffed peppers is usually they don't have enough flavor. They just taste so bland. Every time I've ever had them, I was always left wanting a little bit more flavor. But with these, I'm telling you guys, it has all the flavor you could ever ask for. And the trick is in the seasoning of the beef. That's the trick. I'm gonna show you guys how to make this and I know you're gonna love it. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first three steps are basically just prep work. You want to preheat your oven to 375 degrees, and then you want to prepare your peppers. Now I'm using red peppers. You can really use any pepper you want, but I find red peppers are the best. All you have to do is chop off the top of your pepper, take out the seeds and any flesh that's in the inside. It's really important that you get all the white fleshy parts out because that can cause a bitter taste. Give it a good rinse out to make sure all the seeds are out, and then you're going to submerge each one in a pot of salted boiling water. And you only want to do this for about 4 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes, depending on the size of your peppers. You want to do it until they're just a little bit tender. You got to remember you're going to be putting these in the oven, so you don't want them to be like falling apart. Then take them out, set them on a plate, and just allow them to cool while we work on the rest of the recipe. Now the next prep work you're going to do is preparing your rice. So basically all you got to do is cook the rice according to the package instructions, but I always like to rinse mine 3 times so you get all that extra starch out, because that can cause the rice to become really sticky. And also a little trick, instead of using water to boil your rice, I like to use chicken stock because it adds a little bit more flavor. Anytime you have a chance to add extra flavor, you should do it, because I said so. And once you got your rice cooked, then we can get down to the nitty gritty and start cooking all the insides. See, that took like 60 seconds. It's like so easy. Just kidding, it's called editing. So I have a decent sized skillet here and I just put in my ground beef. Now I like to add my ground beef when my pan is cold and break it up a little bit, then turn on the heat and then start to cook it. Because what that does is when you bring up the temperature of the beef along with the temperature of the pan, you get a better crumbleization, if that makes any sense at all. So now I have my heat on about medium high and I'm gonna start cooking this until it's all nice and brown. And also don't forget to season it with a little bit of salt and pepper, and then we'll go on to the next step. So once you went ahead and made sure you drained off all the excess fat, you can go ahead and put it back on the burner, and now we're gonna season it with the magical seasonings. Now this is actually the same seasonings I use for tacos. So I have some chili powder, some oregano, some ground cumin, some paprika, some garlic powder, and some red pepper flakes. We're gonna go ahead and add that in. And later in the recipe, we're gonna be using some tomato sauce. This is just regular marinara tomato sauce you can get in a jar at the store. I'm just gonna add a little bit to my ground beef. I'm gonna give this a nice stir. We're just gonna cook this, warm this through for a couple of seconds to get all those flavors combined. So this part is done. What I'm gonna do is just put it in a bowl and set it aside for now. So in my same pan, I didn't even wipe it out or anything, I'm gonna add some onion, some zucchini, and the top portions of my red pepper. I forgot to mention that when I do cut the tops of the red pepper off, I like to chop a few of them and put them inside the actual stuffing. And since there's really no oil in the pan, I'm just gonna add just a tiny bit of olive oil. I'm gonna season that with some salt and pepper. My pan is about medium high heat, and all I'm looking to do is soften these vegetables up quite a bit. So saute them for about 5 minutes. Okay, my veggies softened up quite a bit. Now I'm going to add some chopped up mushrooms. Now as you can see, I chopped everything quite small because like I said, you wanna be able to fit everything in the pepper. I'm also gonna add some minced garlic. Of course, I mean, come on, it wouldn't be my recipe unless it had a ton of garlic in it, would it? We're just gonna cook this for another couple of minutes until those mushrooms cook down just a little bit. Veggies are cooked down, so now I'm gonna add the rest of my sauce. I'm gonna add my beef, my rice, and we're gonna give this a good toss together. Now before I forget, I also like to add a little bit of shredded cheddar cheese to give it a little bit of a extra kick. You can't tell me this filling doesn't look amazing. I mean, I would just eat this without the pepper. Now we can start filling our peppers. So I just have them in a regular casserole dish. Obviously, this makes more than 4 stuffed peppers. It really depends on how big the peppers are, but I like to really jam pack these babies. I don't leave any room. Make sure you use your spoon to press down. So the filling should be just enough for about 4 to 6 peppers, depending, like I said, on how big they are. But if you don't want to make that many peppers, you can just use the filling, make some scrambled eggs, and throw it all into tortilla for breakfast the next morning. It's delicious. Now that we have them all filled, I'm just gonna go ahead and top it with some tin foil. And we're gonna throw these in a 375 degree oven for about 40 minutes or until the peppers are nice and tender. And after the first 15 minutes, you can go ahead and take off the foil, put it back in, and at the last 5 minutes, I like to take them out and top it with a little bit of mozzarella cheese, put it back in and put it on broil for about 5 minutes. That way the cheese can get all nice and bubbly and delicious. And that's it. So I'll show you guys what they look like when they're done. So this is the beautiful final product. I mean, come on, if that cheese pull doesn't make you salivate, I don't know what will. And the best part is the pepper is nice and tender. It's not falling apart. It's not totally soggy. It's like the perfect consistency. Bite time. Bite time, it's bite time, it's bite time. Oh my goodness, it's a flavor explosion.
Explosion.
The vegetables aren't overcooked, so they're so mushy. The perfect cook time, the perfect amount of seasoning. I know you guys are gonna love this recipe. So if you do wanna make it, just look in the description box below because I have all the measurements as well as the written instructions. And if you did like this video, don't forget to smack that like button. That was more like a punch. Punch that like button. So as always, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and we'll see you next time.
Peace.